So in last class, I have completed very important scoring chapter, that is matrices. Okay, na? So almost all, I solved all the questions in that chapter. So again, I told you earlier, soon after the lesson, chapter test questions, even multiple choice questions also taking as a assignment questions. Okay, na? Next, another easy chapter, chapter number 22. That is probability. So very important, very easy to also. So you know already, now holidays is going on because of corona effect. Maybe today onwards they'll give some relaxation, maybe, and also some shops are opened. Can I, maybe I'm using the word maybe. So maybe some shops are open today. I'll write some questions, some phrases or some statements on board. Some shops open maybe today onwards. And also you see the climate today, it will maybe rain today, or today's maybe the climate is very cool today, so it may be rain today. And maybe suppose India will win the cricket match against Pakistan. In future days, India will win the cricket match against Pakistan. In future days, I will read out all the statements once again. Some shops are open maybe today onwards after giving relaxation. It may be rain today. India will win the cricket match against Pakistan in future days. So one of the very important point I am going to say. So before going to start every questions or finding every answers in mathematics, basic concepts are very important. So in this chapter, nothing calculation, nothing simplification, only the main thing is basic concepts. Calculation, nothing is there in this chapter, easily you get 3 or 4 marks in this chapter. So now you see here, basic concepts. So what is the meaning of probability? I am explaining now, what is the meaning of probability? Yes, here you see. Some shops are may be open today onwards. It may be rain today. India will win the cricket match against Pakistan in future days. So all three statements are phrases giving uncertainty. Uncertainty means we are not sure about all these statements. Okay, now some shops maybe or may not be, we don't know. It may be rain today because the climate is very cool today. Maybe or may not be. Here I am telling, not in other places. Next, India will win the cricket match against Pakistan in future days. We don't know, maybe Pakistan will win or India will win. So all these three phrases or statements giving uncertainty. Uncertainty means we are not sure about all these statements. Maybe or probably. So these statements gives uncertainty. Uncertainty, measure of uncertainty. Is called as probability. Yes, what is the meaning of probability? Probability is the branch of mathematics deals with the measure of uncertainty. Measure of uncertainty is called as probability. Yes, note down. What is the meaning of probability? Probability is a branch of mathematics deals with the study of uncertainty. Measure of uncertainty is called as probability. Okay, na? Yes, probability. So all these three statements are phrases giving us uncertainty means we are not sure about all these statements. Not sure, probably, maybe, these three words gives uncertainty. So measure of uncertainty in mathematics is called as probability. Okay, na? Yes. Now we are going to discuss about one by one important points. Yes, first one. Just now we have discussed about the meaning of probability. Yes, the meaning of probability is, I'll write definition on board. Probability, note down. Measure of uncertainty by mathematics. Measure of uncertainty by mathematics is called probability. Please note down all these definitions, very important. By using all these definitions, we are going to find the solutions. Next, another very important definition, random experiment. Random experiment. Yes, what is the meaning of random experiment? Suppose before going to start a cricket match or any other matches, we are going to toss a coin. Yes, tossing a coin. Don't write, first you listen carefully. Tossing a coin is an example for experiment. So tossing a coin, then what happens after that? After tossing a coin, so we will consider the face which is the uppermost face. So you have two options. If toss a coin, you have two options, that is head appears, or one more option, tail appears. If tossing a coin, maybe head will turns up or tail will turns up. So we have two options. So these two options are called as possible outcomes. Possible outcomes. So what is the meaning of random experiment? So tossing a coin is example for random experiment. Why it is called a random experiment? If a coin is tossed, maybe head will turns up or tail will turns up. We have two options. Maybe, but we cannot get both head and tail at a time. Maybe head or maybe tail. So that is very important. Or here, head or tail. We cannot get both faces at a time. So head or tail. So head or tail, both including these two, are called as possible outcomes. Very important. Listen carefully. Tossing a coin is example for random experiment. Why it is called a random experiment? So maybe if a coin is tossed once, maybe head will turns up or tail will turns up. So head and tail, including these two, are called as possible outcomes. We cannot say maybe head or maybe tail. So suppose someone said head. If head turns up, means that is the luck. What I told you, that is probability. Maybe, but we are not sure about this. 100% head will come up, no one will say like that. 100% tail will come up, no one will say. Maybe head or maybe tail. So if we got head, if we got tail, that is our luck, that is. Maybe head or tail. So these two are called as possible outcomes. So random experiment means, if a coin is tossed, or an experiment is said to be random experiment, so it satisfies two important conditions. I repeat once again, an experiment is called a random experiment. It satisfies the following two conditions. I will say one by one. So this is the first condition. Condition number one is, it has two possible outcomes, or more than one possible outcomes. More than one. What is the date today? Today date is 29 April 2020. So this is not an example for random experiment. This is 100% sure. But if a coin is tossed, maybe head will turn up or tail will turn up. So two options are there. So more than one possible outcomes. An experiment is called as a random experiment if it satisfies two conditions. Condition number one, it has more than one possible outcomes. Now condition number two, it is not possible to predict outcome in advance. It is not possible to predict. Predict means we cannot say. We cannot say the result of 100% head will turn up. We cannot say. Or tail, we cannot say. If we got head or tail, I told you already, that is luck. So we cannot predict the possible outcomes in advance. So we cannot predict outcome in advance. An experiment satisfies these two conditions, then you can say that yes, it is example for random experiment. Yes, what is the meaning of random experiment? An experiment is called a random experiment. It satisfies two conditions. Condition number one, yes, it has more than one possible outcomes. More than one, compulsory, more than one possible. Maybe two, three, whatever it may be. Yes, next, condition number two, it is not possible to predict outcome in advance. It is not possible to predict, or we cannot predict outcome in advance. If the experiment satisfies these two conditions, then you can say it is random experiments. Now you are all free. Holidays is going on. Almost all people, what they are doing in home, they are playing a dice. Okay, na? Die or dice? Die. Yes, there are three types here. You see, I will write one by one. D-I-E, die. D-I-C-E, dice. And one more, D-I-V-E, die. You see the difference one by one. Die means, so this is the playing instruments. Playing instruments. Dice means, this is a plural of die. Dive while you are playing a cricket, while you are catching the ball. Yes, someone will catch the ball. Yes, by dive. That is dive. Okay, na? Yes, now almost all people, I told you, they are playing dive. Maybe single or dice. Okay, na? Yes, what are the possible outcomes? If a die is thrown, what are the possible outcomes? Maybe one will turn up, two will turn up, three turns up, maybe four. Maybe 5, maybe 6. Just to write comma between the possible outcomes. We cannot get all 6 faces at a time. Maybe 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. So how many possible outcomes it has? Yes, 6 possible. Don't think maximum number is 6, so therefore 6 possible outcomes. No. You can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You count in any order, you get 6. So more than 1, I told you. That's a 6 we got. So this is also example for random experiment. That's what is the meaning of random experiment? If an experiment is said to be random experiment, it satisfies two conditions. Condition number one, more than possible one outcome. More than possible one outcome. Condition number two, it is not possible to predict outcome in advance. If experiment satisfies these two conditions, then we can say that so this is a random experiment. Examples. Tossing a coin once, yes, throwing a die once. If you want, you can say another example. Tossing a coin two times, or two coins are tossed at a time, both are same. Tossing a coin two times, yes. What are the possible outcomes? Yes, maybe both head will turn up. So first hand head, another hand tail, yes, maybe first tail, second head, maybe both times tail turns up. So headed at a time, one head, one tail, first tail, then head, both tail. So these are the possible outcomes if a coin is tossed two times or two coins are tossed at a time. So these are all called, I told you earlier, possible outcomes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. If a coin is tossed two times, there are four possible outcomes. So we cannot predict the outcome in advance. So this is also called as random experiment. Okay, yes, what is the meaning of random experiments? Please note down. An experiment is said to be random experiment. An experiment is said to be random experiment. If and only if it satisfies the following two conditions. I repeat, an experiment, I'll write on blackboard, please note this. An experiment is said to be random experiment if and only if as condition number one, it has more than one possible outcomes. Second condition, it is not possible to predict outcome in advance. So this is very, very, very important. Then the experiment is called as random experiment. So example, tossing a coin, A means a single, once. So this is the description of the experiment, very, very important. Description of the experiment, tossing a coin once. Then possible outcomes are, enclosed in flower bracket, one means head appears or tail appears. Head or tail, he cannot get both faces at a time. I told you head appears, maybe tail appears. So one, two, I told you more than one possible outcomes. So here how many possible outcomes are there? Two possible outcomes are there. Therefore this is example for random experiment. If you want to take one more, no problem. As throwing a die one time or one. What are the possible outcomes? Maybe one will turn up, two or three or four or five or six. So how many possible outcomes it has if a die is thrown only one time? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So six possible outcomes. So this is also example for random experiment. That just now we have discussed. First definition, probability, measure of uncertainty by mathematics is called as probability. Uncertainty, very important. Definition number two, random experiment. An experiment is said to be random experiment if and only if it satisfies two conditions. Condition number one, it has more than one possible outcomes. Next, it is not possible to predict outcome in advance. Example, tossing a coin once, the possible outcomes are head or tail. So head or tail, including both, we call it as possible outcomes. Next, its second example, throwing a die only one time. So maybe you'll get 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. So six possible outcomes are there. So this is also example for random experiments. So many are there. We'll discuss one by one later. Okay, now? So these two are very important. So we'll discuss next remaining definitions in the next class. Good morning, students. So in last class I started chapter number 22, probability. This is very important and very easy to also. So we have discussed already the first one. What is the meaning of probability? So probability is a branch of mathematics, study of uncertainty, or uncertainty can be measured. Uncertainty can be measured mathematically is known as probability. Uncertainty can be measured mathematically is known as probability. Correct? For example, as you, it may be rain today. Okay, na? India will win the cricket match against Pakistan. So these examples gives us uncertainty. We are not sure about this. So that's why probability means measure of uncertainty. Now Second definition, very, very, very important. Random experiment. Second one, very important. Complete chapter depend upon these definitions. So what is the meaning of random experiment? For example, tossing a coin once. Either head appears or tail appears. I told you in last class, head or tail. Head appears or tail appears. So these two results are called as, I told you, possible outcomes. These results are called as possible outcomes. So how many outcomes are there if a coin is tossed once? Yes, two possible outcomes are there. And also, we cannot predict outcome in advance. We cannot tell, we cannot say outcome in advance. So this is also one of the conditions. Then we can say the experiment is called as random experiment. Yes, what is the meaning of random experiment? An experiment is called random experiment if it satisfies two conditions. What are the two conditions? Condition number one, it has more than one possible outcomes. More than one possible outcomes. Condition number two, we cannot predict the outcome in advance. It is not possible to predict outcome in advance. Then we can say that the experiment is called random experiment. Examples: tossing a coin once, tossing a coin twice, tossing a coin three times, or throwing a die once, or throwing a dice once. No problem. All these examples for a random experiment. Now, very important, yes, sample space. Third definition. If you know these definitions, so you can find the very simple answers easily. So very, very important. Yes, what is the meaning of sample experiment? Sample space now. Yes. So sample space is depend upon this one. For example, yes, consider same example. Tossing a coin one time. Tossing a coin one time. So what are the possible outcomes? Maybe head appears or tail appears. So these are the two possible outcomes. And I told you in last class, please note down our enclosed outcomes in flower brasses. So this is denoted by yes. So this is called as sample space. What is the meaning of sample space? Sample space is the set. Consists of all the possible outcomes of a random experiment. Is called sample space. Okay, na? Yes, we take one more, no problem. Yes. Two coins are tossed. Let's take two hands, keep one in left hand and right hand, just to drop the coins. Maybe head appears here. Here also head appears. Let's note down. Yes, on both hands, head appears. So left hand head, right hand tail. So left hand tail, right hand head. Both hands tail appears, for example. Yes, how many possible outcomes are there? Yes, four possible outcomes are there. So this is also example for random experiment. So only these four possible outcomes are there. Other than this, yes, we don't have any possible outcomes. So HH, HT, TH, TT. Write all the possible outcomes within flower brasses. Then it is denoted by yes. So this is called as sample space. So the definition of this is sample space is the set. Note down, sample